JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 1st. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar was found lower against all but two of the other major currencies during the early European morning today. It gained some ground only against the yen, while it was found virtually unchanged against the British pound. The greenback underperformed versus NZD, AUD, CAD, the euro and CHF in that order. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Luni, suggests that markets may have turned to risk on at some point yesterday or today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that European and US indices were a sea of red, but the Asian ones traded in the green. In our view, there was no significant catalyst for the change in investors' morale during the Asian session today, and thus we will see the recovery as another corrective bounce. We believe that investors remain concerned over the new Omicron variant of the coronavirus and what economic impact could the new restrictive measures around the globe could have. On top of that, yesterday we got to hear from Fed Chief Jerome Powell again, who testified before the Senate Banking Committee. Due to the new COVID variant, there may have been expectations that he will adopt a more cautious stance with regards to monetary policy. Nonetheless, he appeared surprisingly hawkish, saying that maybe it is a time to drop the transitory description for inflation, and that due to the increasing risk of higher inflation, they should consider ending their quantitative easing program a few months sooner than previously anticipated. This allowed market participants to maintain bets over a potential rate increase in August and another one by the end of next year, and that may have added some extra pressure to the European and US stocks. The US dollar initially strengthened but came under selling interest today during the Asian morning when sentiment improved. Now, contrary to untouched market expectations around the Fed plans, due to fresh coronavirus-related worries, bets around the December hike by the Bank of England have declined, with market participants now believing that officials may prefer to wait and act after the turn of the year. This is what may have pushed the British pound lower against its US and Eurozone counterparts early yesterday. However, due to its strengthening correlation with risk sentiment lately, sterling rebounded later in the day and early today to recover all the lost ground. Now, moving to the emerging markets world, the Turkish lira fell 5.5% against the greenback after President Tayyip Erdogan once again endorsed aggressive interest rate cuts despite increasing criticism and double-digit inflation. In an interview, Erdogan said that there is no turning back from the new policy direction and that further falling interest rates will improve the exchange rates before the elections. Now, under pressure from Erdogan, the Turkish Central Bank has slashed rates by 400 basis points to 15% since September, and it is expected to cut again in December. With inflation near the 20% mark, this will result in even more negative real rates and thereby more capital outflows. Now, as for today's events, we get the final market manufacturing PMIs for November from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, but as it is usually the case, most indices are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. The ISM manufacturing index for the month is also coming out, and it is expected to have inched up to 61 from 60.8. What's more, Fed Chief Powell will present his testimony before the House Financial Committee. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.